Hey everybody, this is Michael again, and welcome back to the old channel here on YouTube. Well everyone, as you can tell, I'll be giving my thoughts on the second animated film in the trilogy, and of course that film is Godzilla City on the Edge of Battle. Now, for those of you that may have missed hearing my thoughts on the first film in this trilogy, the video is still up on my channel, Godzilla Planet of the Monsters. You can go give it a watch. But if you're a fan of this film, tread lightly, because I am not all too kind to this movie. I felt like, you know, overall, to sum it up, it was a disappointment. There was no imagination. The pacing was really, really slow. Godzilla just was not even in the film until like 53 minutes into it. And I just felt like overall with a medium like this where the sky's the limit, I felt like they just did not take advantage of the format, and pretty much the story basically, even though it takes place in the future, was basically a rehash of many of the Godzilla films that we have seen. And I feel like a lot of the new Godzilla, it's taken so seriously and handled so heavy-handedly that, you know, a lot of the fun has been taken out of these movies. And I mean, you know, yeah, sure, they're giant monsters, there's lots of destruction. You know, I've seen it so many times in so many Godzilla films that, you know, I kind of miss the old Showa era Godzilla films where there was just a lot of fun in those movies. But at any rate, I was not a fan of Godzilla Planet of the Monsters. And as a matter of fact, the title alone, you know, Planet of the Monsters, there was no monsters in it other than Godzilla and a flying creature bird thingy. But so, there you have it. Now, the second film, you know, as dreadful as the first film was, I gotta say that the second film, I would say that I liked it just a little bit. Well, you know, I didn't like the first one, so I can't say I liked it a little bit more. I'll just say that I liked it a little bit. And the film still has a lot of problems associated with this movie that, you know, just bring it down. And overall, even though I like it, overall, it's still a disappointment. And the biggest disappointment to me was that basically we have this medium, like I mentioned, where, you know, we have CGI animation where the sky is the limit, and they don't take advantage of the format, and we still have a film that lumbers along just as fast as Godzilla lumbers along. I didn't hate the movie, but that's not really saying a whole lot, because I felt at the end of the day that it was a missed opportunity. And basically, you know, if I really summed it up, the plot is pretty much just the same as the first movie. They're out to kill Godzilla, which, you know, I don't know if I could really hold that against the film, because there's been several live action films where the plot is basically they're out to kill Godzilla. So you know, it's a lot of the same in comparison to the first film. We have a few more interesting ideas thrown into the mix, but overall, the film is basically a retread of Planet of the Monsters. And once again, you know, we have a world that is inhabited by, you know, the same creatures that we saw in the first film. There's no monsters. And therein lies a big disappointment in the fact that this movie is kind of touted as Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla. You kind of hear the actors or the characters say, hey, you know, Mechagodzilla's still alive. We can use Mechagodzilla to defeat Godzilla. But, you know, and even some of the early promotional art showed Mechagodzilla. So the fans were led to believe that this was going to be a Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla. And I think they even mentioned that in the first film at the end. But, you know, even though I wasn't excited about that, because, I mean, we've had a great majority of the live-action Godzilla films where he fought Mechagodzilla, and I really did not want to see Mechagodzilla again. But at any rate, Mechagodzilla is in the film. Mechagodzilla is nowhere near in the same category or line that we've seen him in feature films. Mechagodzilla is a city. All that we see of Mechagodzilla is a disassembled body, more or less. You see his head. The AI controlling Mechagodzilla for the last 20,000 years has pretty much evolved into a city. Mechagodzilla is a city. Now, I'm not for sure that city can transform into a giant robotic Godzilla, which I was kind of expecting, but that never happened. You just kind of have Mechagodzilla as a city, and this city is, you can't even say this city really fought against Godzilla. I mean, you know, they did use the defenses of the city to battle Godzilla, but it's definitely not a battle royal of Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla. That really doesn't happen in the movie, so that was kind of a disappointment. Instead, we have the humans trying to figure out a way to stop Godzilla, and you know, plans are drawn up. Characters spend the entire movie, you know, developing ideas of how they're going to stop Godzilla. We have an indigenous race of people that were pretty much shown at the very end of Planet of the Monsters, you know, after the credits. I believe it was after the credits. I know it was, you know, either after the main credits or the extended credits. But we saw this this girl save or at least interact with one of the characters, the lead character. We see more of her people. We see that there's a twin. She has a twin sister, which kind of reminds me of a throwback to the Martha twins. And then we have, you know, to me, there's a lot of things in this film that are mentioned, but it kind of just makes you feel like they didn't follow up with it. I mean, you know, we're like, oh my God, we're going to see Mechagodzilla. Then you don't see him. Oh my God, these two little girls, are they the guardians of Mothra? We don't see it. So it's just like, it's a whole lot of much to do about nothing. And I'm not upset nowhere near on the level that I was with the first film, because this one, the pacing is improved, so it moves along on a pretty quick tempo. The action scenes are decent, and I kind of even like some of the scientific ideas presented in the movie. I was entertained by the ideas presented in the film. There's a substance in the movie called nanometal, which you know, the primitive people on the planet that they find coat their spears in this metal. And then I believe later on we find out that Mechagodzilla has also coated the city that has basically become its body with this metal as well. And it's been like 2 weeks since I saw the film, guys, so I'm pulling back on my memory. I do know that, you know, even the people, and having the entire indigenous people on this planet, really, in all actuality, and at the end of the day, they served no purpose other than to introduce the people to this metal that they coat their spears in. That's basically all they do. These people serve no purpose. It's one of those ideas that feels like they started something with it, but they didn't follow it up, and nothing really becomes of these people. They're of no consequence. They're not really even important to the story. And as a matter of fact, I don't even know why you needed them to introduce this metal when you have Mechagodzilla that's coated with this metal. So it seems like the humans would have discovered it at some time or another. And then we have another plot thread where the humans, some of the soldiers, are wanting to use the metal to basically it becomes symbiotic with it, where it becomes part of them and it coats their bodies. They actually do this in the story. This metal is used to coat some of the human bodies, and they become they have a symbiotic relationship with this metal. It coats them. It, you know, it covers their entire bodies, and they use it to or at least want to use it to fight Godzilla. And the movie has some decent ideas, and it feels more like a sci-fi film, and I can appreciate it for that. But, you know, at the end of the day, I just gotta ask myself, do we really need all this stuff? Do we really need all this sci-fi techno babble and all this stuff? Or do we need a film where we have giant monsters battling and fighting, and humanity just trying to get out of the way or survive or counterattack? I just don't know. You know, none of this stuff really does anything to enhance the fact that this is a Godzilla movie. And I would even dare say that perhaps these filmmakers have lost their way in this animated trilogy, because it seems like it's another one of those cases where they're making it up as they go along. And I don't know if they've actually given thought to the entire trilogy. Was a trilogy actually mapped out to where they knew what was going to happen, because like I said, it feels like they're making it all up as they go. And, you know, that's really, really a bad thing to do, because there's no clear direction in this movie. And basically, like I said, it just recreates the plot from the last film, where, you know, you had that Godzilla trying to figure out how to kill that Godzilla. And then this one, you have a bigger Godzilla and you're trying to kill this Godzilla. And, you know, from such a dramatic stance at the end of the first movie, where we see this massively huge mountain-sized Godzilla that, you know, made the one they were fighting look like a juvenile. The massive size of this Godzilla has nothing to do with the story. The fact that he's that big, it doesn't hinder the characters. You know, no one says, oh my god, this creature's huge, we're gonna have to double the amount of energy we need. His massive size does not come into play with anything as far as the attack goes against this creature. And I just feel like there's a lot of technobabble here, there's a lot of planning here, but none of this stuff really goes into making a good Godzilla film. Now, Godzilla was still not in the film very much at all. But I just felt like the ideas and the pacing of the story, it made it not seem as bad. Because, you know, in the first film, I was bored and disappointed that Godzilla was not in the movie. But this one, even though Godzilla's not in it probably as much as, or at least the same as the first movie, it still moved at such a quick pace and had some decent ideas. And even the characters were better off this time around. And even the lead character was nowhere near as annoying as he was the first time. So it moved along at a better pace. Now, like I said, I was entertained by the film, but at the same time, I would still view it as a disappointment. And some of the animated CGI really looked kind of off. Like, there's a scene of Godzilla walking from the front, and it looked totally terrible. So, you know, there's some decent battle scenes in it with Godzilla. There's some decent technology. There's some decent emotional situations. But for all intents and purposes, this film was way off the mark. It's not, in my opinion anyway, not a good Godzilla film. And it's setting up ideas that it never even got close to completing. And even at the very end, one of the alien characters tells the lead guy, you know, our planet was destroyed by this monster. His name was, and he whispers it into his ear and says, never tell anybody this name. But of course, later on, we find out the name is King Ghidorah. He makes Godzilla look like nothing and all this kind of stuff. So now it's like, okay, in the first film, we're setting up Mechagodzilla. He doesn't show up. So now they're setting up King Ghidorah. Is he going to show up? So I don't know, guys. I think the entire film series so far is just a big missed opportunity. I think they could have had so much fun with this series, and they could have made it so entertaining. I think that most people, for the most part, were really excited about seeing an anime Godzilla. And I think the first thing that came to mind was the fact that, oh my god, we can see Godzilla monsters in anime. And I think that, you know, with that in mind, a lot of fans, including myself, were very, very disappointed by the direction these films took. And I, like I said, even though I didn't hate the second film, it was ultimately a disappointment. And it's just, you know, at the end of the day, I sit back and I think, well, you know, these could be a series of films that I'm proudly sitting on my desk and enjoying, and Godzilla and anime. But I have to think, you know, these films suck. Because, you know, ultimately they're just big disappointments. And I just don't understand how it's so hard to do a Godzilla film. And I'm still stuck up there with Star Wars. Why is it so hard to do a Star Wars film or a Predator film or an Alien film? And now, you know, Godzilla is suffering as well. So there you have it, guys. My thoughts on Godzilla, City on the Edge of Battle. What a name. And, I don't know. I don't have any hope. I'm not holding out any hope on the last film in the trilogy, so we'll see. But I will say, guys, that this one failed dismally at the Japanese box office. It did not even make $1 million. $945,000 US. So people aren't happy with the film, and it has flopped hard.